As someone who is in their 40s and rightly having probably one of the worst midlife crises you could possibly imagine, I am now trying to rebuild my gaming collection from my formative years. That's right, trying to actually go back and find all the PS1, PS2, and N64 games that I had from those years between like 13 to 18, and then try and rebuild them. It's been incredibly expensive, in fact, so expensive that some games I'm even outright not even looking at because they cost honestly an exorbitant amount of money. I'm looking at you, .hackquarantine. And I say that because it's one of the main points in today's video. I absolutely love emulation, the fact that people are going out of their way to actually save and actually provide some sort of tangible way for you to go back and play those old video games that aren't for sale anymore, or that you don't want to pay 17 times the actual price of retail of what that game used to be to some scalper because he found it in a garage sale. And to back that claim up, I absolutely 100% condone and even support piracy. Ooh, I know, the big scary word, mind you. I think piracy is honestly preferred in today's day and age because it is in fact a service problem and not a price problem. When the pirated version of the video game plays better, runs better, doesn't need to be always online, and is usually less in storage space and size, that's not an issue with price. That's an issue with the product and the service itself. So why am I talking about piracy and emulation? Well, that's because Denuvo is trying to shed its horrible light of itself and trying to be the good guy in the gaming industry. No, that's right, you heard it here correctly. Denuvo is now trying to turn around and say that it's doing whatever it can to protect video games and video game publishers and developers and not the horrible bad guys who pirate and emulate video games. Whoa, the shame. So let's do the one thing we love to do on this channel, and that's shred apart really illogical takes and ideas, because it turns out that Denuvo's COO thinks they can go ahead and turn this around. In fact, the only way, in my opinion, they could turn this entire thing around is to shutter their doors and close down, because they're doing nothing but causing a pain in the ass for actual paying customers. But let's read the interview from Ars Technica, and then I'll do my thing. As it turns out, the people who make Denuvo are keenly aware of their image in the wider gaming world. In the pirating and cracking community, we're seen as evil because we're helping DRM exist and we're ensuring people make money out of games, Hewan told Ars Technica. Well, that didn't take long now, did it? This guy immediately, the COO of Denuvo, is automatically going to go ahead and start blaming all the people that cracked Denuvo and being like, oh no, we're not the bad guys, we're just keeping DRM alive. I mean, that is the worst thing to possibly do, because you literally don't own the product that you pay for, by the way. That's the whole point of DRM. You don't own it even though you bought it. But Hewan going around and saying, oh no, we're trying to protect the gaming industry and the publishers and developers to make money. They're already making money without you. They don't need you. This is the most... This is literally shifting being the victim as quickly as possible. Oh, no. It's not the consumers and the customers who are the victims that have to deal with our always online DRM. They need to have an internet connection before they even get to play the video game, that have only a set amount of installs per day and when they can actually install their game, even though they have multiple systems possibly. No. It's not them who are the victims. It's the publishers and the developers who are the victims. We're just keeping DRM alive, so we're the bad guys. Yes, you are the bad guys. The fact that, again, in a digital space, we do not own the products we pay for. And the fact that you are then trying to restrict those products that we're giving hard-earned money to is the actual issue. You, in fact, are the bad guys. But let's continue.
But Hewan stressed to Ars that he sees Denuvo as a positive force for the gaming community as a whole. Quote, anti-piracy technologies is to the benefit of the game publishers, but also is of the benefit to the players in that it protects the publishers' investments, and it means the publishers can then invest in the next game, he said. But people typically don't think enough of that.
I cannot believe the way this man has tried to spin his existence in this company. It's shocking to me. Of course the customers do not care about the publishers. Of course they don't see it that way because they're not the publisher. They don't care. The onus of having a sequel for a video game should not rely on the consumer purchasing that game. Oh, I know. Oh, it's going to trigger some people in the comment section. Believe you me. Well, Alex, how are they going to make it if it didn't sell? How are you going to make a sequel if it didn't sell? They have to make a better game then. That's how they do it. That's how they have to actually go ahead and make a game you want to buy, not force you into DRM that's going to restrict you in your system of a purchase that you can't even own because it has DRM included. This is the most stupid thing I've honestly ever seen. Yes, let's place the onus of a sequel that's never been announced, that probably won't get announced, that probably won't ever come down the line because of the fact that you want to have DRM in a game, and then put that responsibility on the customer. Well, you're not going to get a sequel. You know why? Because you weren't a good pay pig enough and you didn't buy enough copies. That's why. No, that's not how this works. They're supposed to make a product that we want to purchase. If the product isn't good enough to purchase, guess what? It's not going to get purchased. That's how this works. Trying to put the onus, again, on the customer or consumer is bullshit. But you know, like I always say, it always gets worse before it gets better. Hewan then continues saying, whether people want to believe it or not, we are all gamers. We love gaming. We love being a part of it. We develop technologies with the intent to make the industry better and stronger. Ah, here we go with the whole kumbaya. Oh, believe it or not, guys, us at the Nuvo, we're gamers too. Yeah. Could you believe it? We're also gamers. We want gaming to be strong. We want gaming to be where it's at. You know what I mean, man? Because we're gamers too, huh, fellow kids? Shut up, you clown. You're a corpo. That's what you're built for. Any company that says this is lying to you directly, to your face. At least have the balls to say, we just want to make money. I respect you more that way if you did, by the way. Jesus Christ.
Aside from generalized philosophical discussions over whether DRM should exist at all, by far the most substantive complaints about Denuvo's tech are about its alleged impact on game performance. Sometimes these accusations come from the crackers themselves and have weighed against strong denials from Denuvo and the game's developer. Other times the accusations come from the game makers, like outspoken Tekken 7 director Katsuhiro Harada, who said in 2018 in a tweet thread that the game's anti-tamper third-party middleware, i.e. Denuvo, was responsible for the frame rate drops in the game. In 2019, an Ars analysis comparing Denuvo free copy of Batman Arkham Knight on the Epic Games Store to a Denuvo laden copy of Steam found no difference in performance. But a series of analysis from YouTube channel Overlord Gaming in 2018 found significant performance differences in games measured directly before and after Denuvo protection was removed.
Ladies and gentlemen, here comes the piece de resistance to the video. Absolutely, Denuvo does in fact impact your FPS. It does impact your game, and it makes your games run worse. There have been mountains of evidence to prove this. I can give you just two examples off the top of my head. The first one is Devil May Cry 5. That's right, that had Denuvo upon its release, and in fact, you saw a 13 FPS drop. And you're gonna say, "Whoa, wait a minute, my guy! It's 180 FPS to 160. Are you gonna notice it?" Yes. You're going to absolutely notice it because it isn't just the fact that it drops a little bit. It is the difference between times and frames that cause the stutter and the issue, which makes it noticeable even if the frame rates are high. And you know what? Let's do another example, by the way, because now we're going to talk about Resident Evil. Oh, that's right. Did everybody fucking forget? Resident Evil had one of the worst implementations of Denuvo DRM. And literally, the moment it was removed, surprise! All the stutters, all the issues, all the frame rate problems that were on PC with that game disappeared. Who could have imagined? Who could have thought that this would actually occur? That a piece of software that is designed to not only make consistent calls to a server to activate or make sure that your purchased copy is actually a correctly purchased copy, constantly, all the time while you're playing, or then trying to do this encoding, decoding thing while you're actually playing, and then harming the actual frame rate of your game or using far too many resources on top of that, wouldn't have an impact negatively on your video game. Surprise, it actually fucking does. And you know, the fact that this guy from Denuvo is like, oh man, we're gonna, Lord Jesus, please help me, Lord. Oh, please help me, Lord. It's just gonna, get ready for this. In our chat, Hewin implied that this kind of public analysis was not very useful because gamers almost never get access to the same version of a game, protected and unprotected. There might be, over the lifetime of the game, a protected and unprotected version, but these are not comparable because these are different builds over 6 months, many bug fixes, etc., which could make it better or worse. And now we've shifted the blame again, says Hewin. Oh, yeah, no. You can't just trust the gamers, by the way, even though, hey, we are gamers. Remember that, Denuvo? You said you guys were gamers too, but then we can't trust the gamers. Surprise! Guess we can't trust you either. Love the logic, by the way. The thing is, your argument holds no water because there have been multiple cases of people having the same version of the same game going through and having a Denuvoed version and Denuvo removed version with nothing changing, and there having be a massive difference in frame rate and frame time. Resident Evil 8 with Digital Foundry that we just talked about proves that fact implicitly. But then again, here you are, but you can't trust the gamers, guys, because the versions they get aren't the same versions that have Denuvo, so, you know, it's got patched, it's better. It's not us, it's the developers that are the problem. That's the blame you're trying to shift. Now the blame has moved from, we can't trust the gamers, you guys aren't buying enough copies, so you won't get a sequel. Actually, the real problem is actually the fucking developer now. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. No, they didn't patch it fast enough with Denuvo. That's why it's bad. It's not us. Why would it be us? We're just going to shift that blame to somebody else and make them pay that price because they're the ones giving us the money anyways. We just need an existence to even be around to make them feel secure in the first place. I can't. Why? How? Is this what it takes to be a COO? I can do this. I can be a COO. I'll be the best COO ever made. I'll be the best. Hewin insisted that Adurto puts in the effort of applying the security and validating that the performance is as it was and is not impacted in the case of anti-tamper. I think there is a clear statement there is no perceptible impact on gameplay because of the way we do things. After the years of public uproar over Denuvo's alleged performance impact, though, Hewin said he knows much of the gaming community won't take him at his word. Our voice is unfortunately not sufficient to convince people because we're not trusted in their mind as a starting point in that debate, he said. Hewin, do you know why your voice is not sufficient enough to actually, I don't know, have people believe in what you're trying to say? Because you've said the dumbest shit possible. Well, not you, but Denuvo itself. You guys have talked about emulation like this, and then turned around and then posted this. So which one is it? Is emulation destroying the gaming industry, or is it not so bad, but there's a dark side to it? How can you sit there and parade these two statements around as an actual fact, because they're not facts, by the way, when the actual gaming industry outright refuses to do anything about game preservation whatsoever, and it's left up to who else but the gamers in order to actually solve that problem, and then do it for free, mind you. The fact that emulators on almost every major console out now exist and run almost flawlessly, there are some few that have a few hiccups, by the way, but that they actually are running in the correct fashion and providing an almost one-to-one experience. And you're saying that there's a dark underside, that you can't trust emulation, that you wonder why, for some reason, your voice isn't able to reduce all the hate that you're getting from your company. Could you put two and two together? Did you take a temperature check, suck your finger, put it out in the air and see where the wind's fucking blowing? Because you don't even know what the hell's going on in your own goddamn company or even trying to say in the first place.
To get around that mistrust, Huyen said, Erdurdo is working on a program that would provide nearly two identical versions of a game to trusted media outlets, one with the Nuvo protection and one without. After that program rolls out, hopefully sometime in the next few months, Huyen hopes independent benchmarks will allow the tech press to see for yourself that the performance is comparable, identical, and that would provide something that would hopefully be trusted by the community.
Oh, yeah. We're supposed to believe you? You guys are gamers, remember? Remember, you said it yourself, the Nuvo are full of gamers. And you also said, well, you can't trust the gamers. So you're going to have an independent study of one game, probably, that you're going to have the Nuvo active, then the Nuvo just turned off, but still in part of the code, not actually fucking removed, by the way, because it takes a patch to remove the code. And even if you crack the Nuvo, it's still going to be active in there. So it's not going to be making the calls out to the server. So it doesn't even matter if you're trying to do this actual test in the first place, because we saw the same thing with Hogwarts Legacy. It doesn't matter if the Nuvo is cracked. If the code is still in the actual base of the game, you're still going to have a frame rate hit, whether it's active or not. And you still don't understand this bullshit. So when you have a game that doesn't have the Nuvo active or isn't implementing the Nuvo, which is really what you're going to be doing, by the way, and a game that is implementing it, it's going to run the same. You're going to be like, see, look, you guys were wrong, huh? Gamers, look, gamers. Look, we made you look like fools from this company that we paid that would totally be completely independent, even though we paid them to do this test. Huh? Wrong again. Gotcha, gamers. Stop crying about that de novo, even though all the other independent actual outlets that do the tests and all the people that do the actual tests of the games and put it on YouTube and everybody sees the actual evidence shows that our software really does impact your frame rate, even though we made one test and paid a company to prove that it doesn't. Do I want developers to get paid for their work? Absolutely. Do I want sequels to some of my favorite games? Absolutely. Do I want these games to be full of DRM, restrict the fact that I purchase these video games, put restrictions on me after trying to say that I don't own the product that I actually purchased, even though they own my $70 now because we made that trade? Absolutely not. And that's really why I'm so angry about all of this. The fact that people are even defending the Nuvo or someone like this COO of the Nuvo is trying to turn around and pass the blame and be the victim of so many other things when it's really just their fault in the first place. So ladies and gentlemen, let me know what you guys think in the video. Are you going to be anti-de novo or do you still support companies like this? And I want to find out exactly why and see what your perspectives are. It'd be interesting to see what your guys' thoughts are so that way I can go ahead and read them and even try to see if maybe I can adjust my perspective. And hopefully I might have changed yours a little bit today too. So if you like this kind of content, you want to see more gaming news, PC port reviews, Steam Deck videos, emulation videos, fanboy content, and even live streams on Saturdays, subscribe to the channel. We're getting close to 48,000 subs. I just want to say thank you, and it means so very much. If you want to join the Discord and have really great access to really funny emotes to spam at me during my live streams, become a member of the YouTube channel. It's about $1 if you want to do so. And if you don't have the ability to spend $1 or you don't want to, that's perfectly fine. I just want to say thank you for watching all the way to the end. That means just as much, if not more as well. And if you want to just hang out on Saturdays during the live stream, I'd appreciate that too. So come on down and hang out. But anyways, y'all, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.